Living New Day by Day with Pastor Ralph LaRosa. He will continue our series, The Church in These Last Days. Let us learn some more essentials of the faith. Also, we will learn about God's amazing grace and how we can receive forgiveness of sins and the gift of eternal life. Here is Pastor Ralph LaRosa.
Let's look at some of the things that are very essential to examine yourself. Okay, so we're going to call this the essentials of the faith. And today we're going to look at six non-negotiables. You know, at School of Tomorrow, when we have our ed cons and so on, they talk about non-negotiables. Every school, every SOT school is different. Every School of Tomorrow, we have one. There's a lot of things different, but there are some non-negotiables, and they talk about that. And that's the same way in the essentials of biblical faith from a Christian worldview. Okay, we're going to look at six today. We'll look at some more in our next lesson. Okay, you ready? The first one, and we'll number them next week, Christ's death on the cross paid the full penalty for our sins and purchased eternal salvation. In John 19:30, Jesus said on the cross, talking about the penalty payment for sin, it is finished. That Greek word, tetelestai, means paid in full. Nothing can be added to it. 1 Peter 2:24, he bore our sins in his own body on the cross. 1 Timothy 2:5 and 6, there's one God and there's one mediator between God and man, God and men, or people, God and people, the man, Christ Jesus. Listen to verse 6, who gave himself a ransom. He paid the price of the penalty for our sins. He redeemed us if we will trust in him. The payment's already been paid. He already paid the ransom. All you have to do is choose to receive it by faith. Now, the second one is his atoning sacrifice. This is very important. This is really good for on a communion Sunday. His atoning sacrifice enables God to justify sinners. That means he gives us his righteousness. It means we qualify to go to heaven, okay? It means the sin is no longer a problem. It's been paid for and we accepted it. And how do we accept it? Freely, without compromising the perfection of divine righteousness. Listen to me. If there's one thing that God cannot do, is compromise his perfection, his righteousness, his justice, his holiness, his integrity. He will not compromise that for anyone. And God, not us, God found a way to justify us, to qualify us, to go to heaven freely without compromising his perfection. 1 John 2:2 says, he is the atoning, this is talking about Christ, the only righteous one. He is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. And then it says, not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. If anyone goes to hell, it's because they rejected this atoning sacrifice. They refused to receive the benefits. They refused to repent, to change their mind and trust in this atoning sacrifice. And they go to hell because they rejected the truth. They rejected the gift. They broke the law and they didn't accept the mercy and the remedy from God himself. Okay, listen to these verses. Romans 3:24 and 25. And we are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. Listen to this. God the Father presented him, God the Son, as a sacrifice of atonement. He fulfilled all of those animal sacrifices, beginning all the way back in with Adam and Eve and that first sacrifice, going through the Levitical priesthood. Through faith in his blood, they looked forward. It covered their sins year after year. And to finally, on the cross, Christ paid in full, took them away. He did this to demonstrate his what? His justice. He didn't compromise to do this. Because in his forbearance, That means we should have been judged. We should have been cast into the lake of fire. But he found a way to justify us, to redeem us. Forbearance means he left the sins committed beforehand unpunished. People are waiting in a place called torments to go to the great white throne judgment, to be thrown in the lake of fire in Revelation chapter 20, and they will be judged based on this. But God held back. And in Acts 17:30, it says, the times of that ignorance God allowed, but now it's been paid for. He commands all men everywhere to repent. And then, of course, the next one, amazing grace. Salvation is by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ alone, plus or minus nothing. Ephesians 2:10, for it's by grace you have been saved through faith. This is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. This is a non-negotiable, essential. Nobody gets to heaven except by grace. It's a gift, and no one can add one thing to this payment. Okay? Now let's talk about between God consciousness and gospel hearing. Okay, we call this the period of common grace. And listen to this, God requires of those who are saved no preparatory works. People don't reform, and then when they're good enough, God saves them. That is a false doctrine. You come just as you are, with everything that's negative, all of your flaws, all of your sins, and the big illustration is the Apostle Paul on the road to Damascus. Listen to this in 1 Timothy 1:15. Here is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief, and whom I am the worst. And listen, on the road to Damascus, he did not self-reform. He witnessed the stoning of Stephen, but he was not converted. And he didn't get better. He probably got worse until he met the Lord Jesus on the road to Damascus. The gift by grace does produce works. Eternal life is a gift from God. Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Believers are saved and fully justified before their faith produces even a single righteous work. Listen to Ephesians 2:10. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand, even before we believed, and he knew we would believe by his foreknowledge that we should walk in them, and that's a choice. So do saints sin? Okay, I'm going to let you in on a secret. All believers are saints. They're hagios. They're set apart. Okay, Christians can, and they do sin. Listen to 1 John 1:8. If we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. 1 John 1:10, if we say that we have not sinned, we make God a liar, and his word is not in us. By the way, 1 John 1:9, you can confess your sins and be forgiven. So the times of refreshment is available to you. Acts 3:19, repent, turn to God, that your sins may be wiped out, and the times of refreshment may come. And now is the accepted time. So what's the solution? Repent, change your mind, trust in Christ, believe in him, follow him, give your life to him, and you'll find the times of refreshment.
Thank you once again for listening to Renewed Day by Day with Pastor Ralph LaRosa. Pastor Ralph will continue with the church in these last days and some more essentials of the faith on our next broadcast. Until then, God bless you and stay healthy.